Let's now continue our discussion on the so-called gentleman's agreement between former President Duterte and China. We're now joined by former Senator Antonio Trillanes. Senator Trillanes, good morning to you, sir.
Good morning to you, Ms. Karen, and to our viewers.
All right. Now, you are calling Senator Imee Marcos to initiate an investigation regarding the so-called gentleman's agreement, correct?
Yes, Ms. Karen.
Okay. Go on, Senator. Okay.
I think the public needs to know what really happened and what's the Philippine interest in that secret deal with Mr. Duterte and China. And also, probably it's the best time to shed light also on the back channel talks back in 2012, because they keep on insinuating and deflecting the issue by pinning the blame on myself and Aquino administration. So I think we need to get these things out in the open, and I'm willing. For the past 6 years under the Duterte administration, they had access to all the documents in DFA and in Malacanang, but they couldn't find anything to remotely connect or anything that will say na binenta ko at ni Pinoy yung Scarborough. On the contrary, and you can check your records, during that time, during the standoff in 2012, almost 100 ships of China swarmed Scarborough Shoal, both inside and outside the shoal. And right now, only 3 ships remain. And because of those 3 ships, yun ang reason kung ba't nag-file ng arbitration kay si President Aquino. And we won that. So it's not correct to say that we lost Scarborough, because in fact, walang Chinese ships doon sa loob ng shoal at walang reclamation doon. So I think the media should also correct yung statement na we lost Scarborough in 2012, because by saying so, kinoconcede natin, binibigay natin sa China. Hindi ganon.
Okay, so let's talk about a few things now. There were several points you mentioned, but let's talk about Ayungin Shoal first, okay? Yeah. So for the viewers, Ayungin Shoal is where BRP Sierra Madre is right now. It's quite symbolic for the Philippines that it's established a presence there. So first, former Secretary Panelo came out with a statement and said, there is no such gentleman's agreement. He talked to Duterte about this, and Duterte claims he never entered into any gentleman's agreement with China regarding specifically Ayungin Shoal. So Attorney Harry Roque responds, yes, not regarding Ayungin Shoal, but there was a gentleman's agreement to keep its status quo regarding the disputed territories during that time. So let's start with that first, that Attorney Harry Roque says, what's not working is the stand of this administration. He describes it as microphone diplomacy. And he says, if this administration continues its hardline stance against China, there's a risk that we can actually lose Ayungin Shoal.
Okay. Well, I beg to disagree, because what we had during the Duterte administration, during their term, is so much worse. Remember, they gave away so much, hindi lang dun sa West Philippine Sea, kundi dito rin, internally, you know? Yung remember, yung mga pogos na pinapasok nila dito, yung China telco na ngayon, andirito na ngayon sa, even inside our military camps. So yan, ano? Plus among other lopsided deals. Ano? Kaya nga, sila ang kumita rito, sila Duterte and company, no? I forgot to mention yung Pharmaly tsaka yung Sinovac. Magkano ang kinita nila? They gave so much favors sa China. in exchange pa doon ano by giving away so much doon sa natural resources natin doon sa West Philippine Sea. So we did not gain anything. Okay, sabihin mo merong siyang policy of appeasement, but at least ngayon ay for that matter dito sa Marcos administration you don't have that, ano, similar yung Aquino administration and the Marcos administration as regards the West Philippine Sea policy. So maaring sabihin natin na meron tayong konting kiskisan every rotation mission, but at least intact yung ating ano national integrity, ano, yun.
So it's interesting you said that because, yeah. I mean, considering the Marcos and Aquino history, that the Pinoy administration and the BBM administration have similar policies regarding the West Philippine Sea. And you're right. And Attorney Harry Roque says, I wanted to ask you this. Doesn't it show already that it doesn't work? So that's what he was saying. He was saying that at the end of the day, even if it sounds good, it doesn't work. In other words, China won't give in. So isn't there a risk, he says, that I'll read the quote. He said this, count this, I said it on Head Start. The Philippines will be forced to remove its soldiers from Ayungin because of starvation and dehydration if we continue this hardline stance.
No, that's fear-mongering. And I think that's the narrative that China wants to spread, no? And it's ironic that Filipinos are spreading that Chinese propaganda. Now, we have a template. During the Aquino administration, President Noynoy Aquino stood his ground. Again, we resorted to diplomacy, not war. Yun nga yung backchannel negotiations. And as
I mentioned, you were appointed, let's remind the public, yes, in 2012, yes, you were appointed actually by the president or chosen to, yes, actually get those backchannel negotiations. But that's just a little bit of context there. But let's move forward. Let's go with Ayungin first before we go back to Scarborough.
Ayungin. Yes, but that is the template. What happened in Scarborough can be the template. Okay, so that's the diplomatic approach. As you mentioned, so I was the designated backchannel negotiator. The situation there was so tense. Muntik na magkaputukan doon, ano? Almost 100 ships ang nag-swarm dyan sa Scarborough, pero nawala yon. Nawala sila na humupa yung tension and buong Scarborough, tayo pa rin. Wala silang reclamation dyan. Walang mga fishing vessels or Coast Guard ships ng China sa loob ng shoal. No? Tatlong naiwan doon sa labas and that was a mistake by China. Because of those three na nag-insist sila na mag-iwan sila ng tatlong barko doon sa labas, doon niya yung nag-file na arbitration case si President Aquino. And ayun na ngayon, na-negate yung kanilang 9-dash line forever because of that mistake. So, yun na ngayon ang template mo na hindi sabihin that you're standing your ground, eh suddenly magkakagera. And that's going to be the same thing dito. Okay, let's go to Ayungin. Maraming pwedeng paraan para mag-resupply.
Okay.
I believe yung ginagawa ng Marcos administration is the right path. They're drawing international attention.
And I think that's right. Because Attorney Harry Roque said it's good PR-wise. He said, but diplomacy-wise, he doesn't agree with it. Because he said diplomacy, for example, is exempted from freedom of information. There's so many things you should be doing behind the scenes quietly that need not be announced. So you think this is good?
So yun na nga, no? Again, yung template dun sa back channel talks, under the radar yon. Okay, under the radar, maraming na nagawa. Kaso nag-insist silang iwan yung tatlo, eh, no? They, kumaga, pinaalis nila yung 80 to 100 ships, pero nag-iwan sila ng tatlo sa labas. And because of that, doon nag-draw ng international attention si President Aquino through the arbitration case, and we won. Ngayon, ganun din dito sa Ayungin. pagka hindi sila ano diyan umayos diyan sa or they keep on doing or harassing yung ating resupply missions. Eh ngayon, ito na ngayon, we're drawing international attention and they don't like that, no? So sila ngayon ang mag-step back diyan. Okay, there are so many ways to resupply yung mga barko na yan, ayang BRP Sierra Madre na yan. And ito naman, I think back during the GM administration, ang pinakamalaking pagkakamali nila dyan is yung tinanggal nila yung Navy personnel doon sa BRP Sierra Madre at pinalitan nila ng mga Marines. Okay, yung mga Marines magaling yan sa mga digmaan, pero they don't know anything about maintaining a Navy ship.
Ah, okay.
Yung Navy personnel, yan ang bread and butter ng Navy, no? Kita nyo na maintain yung mga World War II vessels sa Navy. Dito, sila dati naka-assign dyan. So, they're doing the repair regularly, no? Kaso pinalitan nila yan, eh. No?
Kailan pinalitan, sir? Ngayong administration lang?
No, during the GMA administration.
Okay.
So they thought kasi na it's an outpost, so siguro ang ilagay nila is Marines. Pwede ka naman maglagay ng Marine squad dyan, pero dapat yung Navy personnel nando doon pa rin kasi that's what they do. Marunong sila mag-maintain ng naval guns, nung deck, ano? Kaya nakita nyo, parang dilapidated. Hindi nangyayari yan sa Cavite Naval Base, ano? Kasi ano yan eh, instinctive yung maintenance culture ng Navy.
Okay, so one thing you've commented on is in a way the change of personnel. It should be Navy personnel. But then Attorney Harry Roque suggested that perhaps decommissioning BRP Sierra Madre and changing the personnel and putting Philippine Coast Guard personnel, then it becomes a civilian ship, right? Would that help in the situation? Would that lessen the tension?
No, that's a trap, okay? And that's what China wants. Okay, remember, kaya hindi ginagalaw yung BRP Sierra Madre, kahit theoretically, kayang-kayang i-overrun PLA yan, ng Chinese Armed Forces, but since a commissioned ship siya ng Philippine Navy, it may trigger the Mutual Defense Treaty. So the moment you decommission that, then it's now vulnerable, no? Pwede na silang iharas ng iharas until mag-alisan yan. And yun na nga, no? Ang pag-AFP personnel kasi, talagang they hold their ground, they stand their ground. Hanggang mamatay yan, no? Kaya nila yan. So pag naglagay tayo ng civilians kasi dyan, eh syempre, baka pagtakutin, tatalo na lang sa lifeboat at i-abandon yung post. Yun po.
And you said something interesting that it's a trap. It's what China wants. Mm-hmm. Do you see Attorney Harry Roque taking China's line?
That's very obvious, ano? Hindi lang si Harry Roque, si Duterte mismo, no? During the Duterte administration, ganun sila. Ano sinabi ni Duterte? Gawin nyo na lang Philippine province of China, no? Sinabi niya to sa atin and everybody was laughing, but apparently inaano niya na, no? Nino-normalize niya na yung pag-submit niya sa China. So ito, sinasabi naman niya nila Harry Roque. Now si Panelo, don't mind that guy, no? Ano lang nila yon, eh? Panggulo nila yon, no? That's going to be a big mistake for the media to actually believe in anything Mr. Panelo says. Ngayon, ito si Harry Roque, yan ang linya ng China, yan ang linya ng mga Duterte. And dapat yan ang kailangan nating imbestigahan, no? And that's why I'm calling for the Senate or even the House to open the investigation. Sige na, malaman na natin lahat yung secret deal niyo dyan sa China at itong backchannel talks kasi palagi nilang kumbaga nagiging whipping boy kami ni President Aquino pagka may problema sila. They deflect and misdirect. kahit na time and again, paulit-ulit ako nag-explain what really went down. Yan po.
Okay. My last question now would be the Maritime Council that President Marcos just formed, no, after issuing EO 57. China has reacted to this. What do you think of the timing of forming this Maritime Council?
Okay, I think it's very timely, no? Kasi ang difference kasi niyan, baka iisipin ng ano, no, anang layman, outsider na ano lang naman 'yan, what anong magagawa niya, no, parang reorganization lang.
Uh-oh.
Hindi po, no. Yung pag reorganize na 'yan is we're basically setting up a crisis management organization para kung hindi lang pag-strategize o policy setting, kundi anything that happens there, meron ka ng mekanismo to handle the crisis, no? And that's very important for a country to have, no? Meron silang way to get and gather information so that they can make sound and timely decisions during moments of crisis.
Okay. On that note, I want to thank you so much, former Senator Antonio Trillanes, for joining me today. Thank you, sir.
Maraming salamat, Ms. Karen.